Hi, I'm Alicia, and today I'm going to show you how to block websites on Chrome. Are you looking for an easy way to block a website on Google Chrome so that you or other users can't access it? Whether you want to keep yourself from getting distracted by blocking YouTube or Reddit, or block inappropriate websites not covered by parental controls so your children can surf the web safely, we've got you covered. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in this video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, you ready? Let's block some distractions. The easiest way to block a website on a desktop version of Chrome is to use an extension. There are many options available, but BlockSite is the most up-to-date and has over 1 million active users. Simply search for BlockSite in the Chrome Web Store to go to the extensions page. Then click the Add to Chrome button and confirm the request by clicking Add Extension in the install prompt. Once you've added the extension, it'll ask for your permission to record browsing data, which you can deny. After that, you'll see the app's user interface where you can add your very first blocked site. Type in a URL and press enter to block any website, for example, reddit.com. Now, if you try to revisit Reddit in the middle of your working day, you'll see this option pop up instead. Instead of endless subreddits, a disappointed puppy will motivate you to get back to work. By default, no extension settings apply to the incognito mode, and BlockSite is no exception. So to make sure you block a site while using Chrome's incognito mode as well, head to the extension settings. If you already closed the tab, you should be able to find the BlockSite extension in your toolbar. From there, navigate to the settings page and click the Enable Incognito Mode button at the very top of the page. Now, even if you try to access your blocked pages in incognito mode, you can't reach them. Whether you're a concerned parent or an office manager wanting to boost productivity, you need to take one more step. If you just use the extension, users can simply find the plugin page and unblock the pages without issue. To avoid this, you need to add password protection to the extension. To do so, go to the BlockSite Details page and navigate to the Password Protection tab. From there, check your first option, enter your email address and desired password. Once you've signed up and logged in, all Chrome users will need to log in to make changes. If you don't want to permanently block websites, but rather temporarily block distractions as you're working, BlockSite also offers that option, but to use it, you need to have the extension pinned. So if you can't see the icon in your toolbar, you'll need to add it by clicking the puzzle piece and then pinning BlockSite. Next, click the BlockSite icon in your toolbar, navigate to the Work Mode tab, and click the Get Started button. Then you can add the sites you want to block to a list and click Continue once you've added them all. Next, you can set the work and break intervals. By default, it's set to the Pomodoro technique interval of 25 minutes on, followed by a 5-minute break. You can also set it to an 8-hour workday. To get even more stuff done, check out our list of the best Chrome extensions for your WordPress users to boost productivity. Don't want to use a Chrome extension to block websites? You can block websites completely taking advantage of two additional ways. One, as long as you're an administrator, you can edit the host's file to restrict access to sites. Two, you can block websites at the router level, stopping your children or employees from accessing distracting sites on any Wi-Fi connected device. In Windows, you can block websites for Chrome and all other web browsers by using what's called the host's file. It's located in the following folder. Make sure you open the host's file with Notepad or another basic text editor. From here, you want to add lines with your localhost IP in front of any domain you want to block, like this. Add the new lines of code after the last commented line that starts with a hashtag. Make sure that there is a space between the localhost IP address and the website domain names. Now press Ctrl plus S or save manually from the menu to update the file. Do not save the file with a TXT extension. If you get a prompt that doesn't let you save the changes, you may have to reset the file permissions. To do this, right-click the file and select the Properties link from the drop-down menu. Give your user full control permissions and click Apply. Now you should be able to edit the file contents and save it without issue. Try to save the file again, and you should be successful. Now that you've saved the file, it's time for the moment of truth. Open up Chrome and try to visit one of the blocked sites. If you've done everything right, you shouldn't be able to access any website on the list from any browser. You won't even be able to start loading the page. For macOS users, things aren't much different. Here's what you should do. Open your terminal and type the following command. Then, move your cursor to the last line and add all websites you'd like to block following this structure. Once you've added all websites, save your edits and exit the file. To make sure all changes have been implemented, you may need to flush your DNS cache. If your router has a feature for blocking websites on your network, you can use it to block websites in Chrome and other browsers. Actually, it'll block the sites on any Wi-Fi connected device, including tablets and mobile phones. Many routers use 192.168.1.1 as their default IP address, but that's not always the case, so you'd need to confirm their address. The first thing you need to do is find your router's IP address so you can access the settings. To find your router's IP address on Mac computers, open the System Preferences by clicking on the Mac icon. Next, open the network window. From here, you'll need to choose the relevant connection, either Wi-Fi or Ethernet, and you can use the IP information under the status. Do you have a Windows computer instead? Here's how to find your router IP. On Windows computers, you can open Command Prompt by searching for CMD and pressing Enter. After you open it, type ipconfig and press Enter. You'll see your router's address under Default Gateway. Copy and paste the address into your browser to access your router. Next, you'll need to edit your router settings. To do this, you need to have the administrator login information for your router. If you didn't change it, it's written on the documents or box that your router came in. Copy and paste the address in Chrome, and you'll see an admin login prompt. The final steps depend on your router. For example, Netgear routers have blocked site settings under the Security tab. From there, you can scroll down to a Block Sites section and block websites by keywords or domain names. Type a domain name into the field, click the Add Keyword button, and you'll successfully block the website through your router. Unlike with desktop computers, it's not the exact same approach for different devices here. The iPhone offers better native privacy settings, which means you don't need an app to block sites. The easiest way to block websites on an Android phone is to use the Block Site app. First, you need to search for and install the app in the Google Play Store. Then, you need to edit your accessibility settings to give the app access. The app will walk you through this. On most phones, the Block Site section is at the bottom of the settings. After that's done, you can start blocking websites on your phone. Click the plus sign to start blocking your very first site. Search for a keyword or domain name and choose the website or app you want to block. Once you've selected the site, tap Done to save your settings. You've now officially blocked your first site on Android. If you try to visit a blocked site, you'll see the same disappointed puppy as on your desktop computer. If you have one of the newer iPhone models, you don't even need to install an app to start blocking sites. You can do it from within the iPhone settings. First, go to the General Phone Settings screen and scroll down to the bottom and tap the Screen Time link. From here, you can choose one of the options available: Unrestricted Access, Limit Adult Websites, Allowed Websites Only. Choose the Limit Adult Websites option and you can start adding specific websites to never allow. When you've added websites to the list, you won't even be able to start loading them, whether you connected to your home Wi-Fi or data plan. Blocking websites is half the story here, as notifications can also disrupt and ruin your productivity. So let's take a look at how to stop them in Chrome. To block a notification, you don't need an extension or to edit any files or OS settings. You can block push notifications from sites in Chrome's general privacy settings. You can get there instantly with this URL. Or navigate to the settings screen and click Privacy and Security. Next, head to Site Settings and click through the notifications page. Now you can either stop sites completely from asking for permission to send notifications or block individual sites by URL. The mobile version of Chrome for iOS, iPhones and iPad, has notifications turned off by default, so there's no notification setting and no need to edit them. While on Android, it's even easier to block notifications than on the desktop version. Here's how to do it. Open up Chrome, click the More button in the corner, scroll down, and tap the Settings link. Once there, scroll down and click the Notifications link. From here, you can turn off all app notifications, including all sites, with a single tap. If you want to block the notifications from a specific site, you can scroll down to the Sites section and tap the button next to the site in question. If you follow the steps here in this video, you can easily block websites on Chrome on any device you desire. You'll no longer need to be plagued by distractions on your computer, mobile, or tablet. Now it's your turn. How do you prevent distractions from ruining your workflows? Which apps are you using? Share them in the comments section. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.